you think of the Great Barrier Reef, the world's largest coral reef system.
This is the most amazing thing I have ever seen.
What do you picture? What do you imagine? It may be the largest living structure on Earth, and it may be hundreds of miles away from where you live. Out of sight and out of mind. So let's go down under and join some ordinary citizens like you and I who are documenting change down here, now that 50% of the reef is now lost.
This section of coral just beneath us here has been split right down the middle due to Cyclone Debbie. Unbelievable, let's go take a look.
You jump in the water, you look at the categories, and it's your visual assessment what's going on with the reef. You will be tracking change.
But before we go on, I have to explain how we got here and how we bumped into and met these amazing people.
Welcome to the Whitsundays!
While sailing up the East Coast on our floating home to Tucana, we met Lindsay and her volunteers while they were picking up rubbish on Middle Percy Island. What's your boat called?
We're just sort of collecting marine debris, so...
I thought that's what you guys might have been doing.
I told them I had a small YouTube channel and that I'd love to share their story. And so after a few weeks and several text messages later, we meet again. Morning, everyone. We're in a bit of a rush today. We're going to be going to check out the reef. So we're going to quickly whip up some breakfast while we're having a quick chat. Are you happy with sun-dried tomatoes?
I'm happy.
Are you?
Please.
Sugar. Okay, dehydrated tomatoes coming right up. So, what's the plan today? What am I doing?
Cooking breakfast.
I am heading out to the reef. I am so excited. We're leaving you behind though, sorry. Last time I was here was about 5 years ago and there was a massive Category 5 cyclone that whipped through here. And
was it?
Yes.
We want to get now to one of our reporters.
We're expecting these waters to rise another metre with the high tide plus the storm surge.
The reef was significantly damaged, so we're going to be heading back out today. Recently asked you guys on Instagram if you were interested in checking out the reef, and actually 98% of you said that you were. Ah, this is burning! Oh gosh, I think I've got to turn this pan down, it's really burning up. So we're going to do that today here in the Whitsundays. We are in Pioneer Bay and we are right at the back of the bay. It is packed in here. The drone footage really does it justice. We'll quickly have some breakfast. John's going to take me to shore and we'll meet the crew and tell you about what we're up to today.
We'll be about half an hour before we need to pick up.
This is the first time we won't see each other for the whole day in like 4 months.
Have fun.
We're swapping to Tucana for a tall ship today. We are going to be heading out on Providence. She's the classic 62-foot gaff-rigged schooner, a replica of the American Blackfish. Lindsay actually has taken us out today to go coral monitoring. She owns Providence and has planned this special expedition for us and her staff. So where exactly is Skipper Pete taking us to?
We're in the Mull Channel here at the moment, about to go past North Mull. Then we're going to be in our beautiful Whitsunday Passage. 5 years ago, we had a cyclone come through here. It was called Cyclone Debbie. She packed winds of about 320 kilometres an hour. It blew the reef apart. So the coral that we're going to be seeing today is roughly around about 5 years old. We see it growing every day.
But 5 years ago, I was out here reporting on the cyclone. And back then, we didn't talk about the reef, rather the destruction on land.
Right now, Cyclone Debbie is 85 kilometres offshore.
We were talking about the impact on families, on businesses and houses, but we weren't reporting on the fact that the reef was, would you say decimated? Is that too big of a word?
Totally decimated. Whole bays were wiped out. And there was a lot of pressure not to say anything about that.
So let's take a look 5 years on. We're heading out to the northeast of Whitsunday Island to collect important data on the reef with Whitsunday sailing.
So we can track the change of what's happening to the reef. Check its recovery from impacts like coral bleaching, crown of thorns, and most recently, Cyclone Debbie.
Right, it's time to get into our togs and we're going to do some diving.
Woo! Steve Fisher is the project officer with Reef Catchments.
The waves have come up here and smashed this piece of coral off, and it's broken off, and it's laid down on the deck. It looks like someone's taken a mower and mowed it down, but it's still alive. It's growing, it's recovering. Coral's coming around, it's coming back to life. You see all this new coral coming back and recovering and repopulating this area. And you see little pieces coming back. You dive down, have a closer look.
Unbelievable, let's get take a look.
I don't know why I felt the need to share this story with you, and I'm not really sure you even care to be quite honest, but the reef is precious, and recently UNESCO made the recommendation for it to be listed as an in danger World Heritage Site.
It's important to talk about something like that so something's done about it. Like, I'm horrified about the UNESCO decision not to place it in danger.
So you think it should have been called in danger?
Absolutely, it's in danger. 50% of it, according to the Great Barrier Reef Marine Park Authority Outlook report, has died, and its outlook is very poor, quote unquote. That's not me.
Oh, that was something really special.
Before getting into tourism, Lindsay used to be a reporter. She's not afraid of speaking out, and in this picturesque paradise, she's actually encouraging her staff to teach tourists about the reef here in the Whitsundays. She's not just selling the dream.
They're sort of fighting for where to actually take people to snorkel. Again, you're not supposed to say anything like that, but if we don't say something...
Lindsay is referring to the Whitsundays, but remember, the Great Barrier Reef is vast. It's bigger than the United Kingdom, Switzerland and Holland combined, spanning more than 2,300 kilometres. As John and I plan to sail north, we'll show you in our upcoming episodes how some of the reefs are thriving, while the other half look like desert wastelands.
What you can do to contribute to science is you go back to the same site once a week, you jump in the water, take your sheet with you, you look at the categories, and it's your visual assessment what's going on with the reef. You will be tracking change.
But for Lindsay and her staff, they're starting small and they're starting local.
Completely like cut and half.
Something that we can do too, and this is where it gets interesting.
What we're actually trying to do is go to these beaches where we met you. So we found 1,000 bottle tops just on one beach in the Percy's. Toothbrushes, children's toys.
The Percy's are meant to be pristine Great Barrier Reef islands. But this is the reality. We witnessed it for ourselves.
There's a sign about rubbish, right, on the beach and stuff.
That actually looks like something's tried to bite into it. So, what's the solution?
So we're at Peter's Bay and we're going to be doing a bit of a cleanup. So this is part of the program. Rubbish is analysed so they can sort of work out where it's come from. They were saying that a lot of the rubbish that they find are actually bleach containers that have come all the way from Asia.
When life gets you down, you know what you gotta do?
I don't wanna know what you gotta do.
Just keep swimming, just keep swimming, just keep swimming, swimming, swimming.
And believe it or not, Finding Nemo may have contributed unintentionally. With the demand for aquarium fish, illegal overseas fishermen were known to use bleach and sodium cyanide to stun the fish.
One of the first things happened was there was a huge uptake of people wanting clownfish for their fish tanks. So of course, where they're collecting from, the wild, so there was a decline in clownfish living in anemones. They'd come out to some anemones, all the clownfish would have been gone, so there's no protection for the anemone.
And as for our coastline,
what have you found already?
It is a oil drum.
There's heaps of microplastic all in the sand here. Stuff that keeps breaking down, it turns really, really small.
It doesn't actually break down, it just breaks up into smaller pieces.
This isn't scaremongering, this is real.
This is real. We're now finding turtle hatchlings that are dying. They're cutting them open and their gut are small with microplastics. Microplastics is a broad term. It's generally something smaller than your fingernail. Because when a hatchling is born, there's no maternal care, so it doesn't know what to eat. So it goes into the current, it goes out after a couple of days, it goes, bit of seaweed, taste it. Bit of plastic, taste it. And plastic is the same color as jellyfish. And we're finding them dead with food and agar.
Unbelievable.
And that's true.
This isn't just about what's happening here on the Great Barrier Reef, but if people are educated in this way, they can do something in their local community as well.
This is what it's all about. We're trying to do our bit up here, but we need help. Right? This is a worldwide issue and everyone can do their bit.
I'm so excited to share this knowledge with John, who's back on Tucana once again, tearing the boat apart, making it safer. He's fixing the rope clutches on the cabin top. The cams were all worn out and the lines were slipping. It's a big job, but someone has to do it. We have some wild weather coming out. Might get a little wet in a second. What is she? We just randomly met Lindsay on Middle Percy, and I just thought that this was such an incredible and important message to share with the world and the community.
I deeply feel we met Lindsay for a reason, and I'm so grateful for this platform to share their story with you. So if you want to continue sharing for the sake of all the little Finding Nemos out there, go for it. On your socials, or just even a small comment with your thoughts below. Like, were you surprised by what you saw here today? And if you like this video and you subscribe, all those little things will help to get the word out. Better still, you could come out here and get involved.
You're not only going to enjoy the experience and walk away feeling like you've contributed, but you'll also meet some new people and contribute to the Great Barrier Reef. P.S., how are you going with that, by the way?
Oh, I'm glad you asked.
Let's continue this chat next week before our sail north.